I think that Rosa Parks her painting was a little milestone kind of turning point for me, because I knew who Rosa Parks was. I learned about her in school, as everybody does. But when I really learned about her, like really sat down and listened to her speak in her old age in interviews, she at like, I don't remember, 80 some years old, was still in every interview that she did, was adamant in the very beginning. My feet did not hurt. Everybody can be like, oh, she's a sweet little granny and her feet hurt. No, she was an ass kicker. She was a trained activist. She was in her, maybe she was 40, she was young. And I was like, obviously that's such a thing that she's sick to death of hearing that. I had to go back and really examine, why did I learn that? Who told me that? Why is that in every book ever? And then you gotta think a little deeper, like, what does that mean? Why would that even exist? And the reason that exists is because she was portrayed as a feeble, tired, little old lady who just did her work during the day and then got on the bus and was just tired, damn it, and she just wanted a break. In a white society, that's a very palatable, kind of easy to digest version of what happened. She was utilized by an organization that was ready for change. The Montgomery bus boycott happened. That was the catalyst of it, but it was something that had been brewing and people had been talking about, and she was a badass. And that would have been a much less palatable thing to sell to white school children, I imagine, is that this really pissed off badass black woman who knew exactly what she was doing said no, because that's not something that women, that black people in general, not just women, were supposed to do at that time, was say no, I'm not doing that.